Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at Safari's Reader View. So using Reader View is pretty straightforward. First, you find yourself at a page that's an article. So it could be a newspaper page or a blog or anything that's just got some text on it. And here you can see the text of this article on the left. There's a lot of other elements to the right and to the left and lots of stuff to distract you. If you want to just focus on the text, then Reader View is for you. Now the way to see if it's available is to look at the top here in the address bar and look for this little symbol here. If I roll my cursor over it, you can see it says Show Reader View, and all I have to do to activate Reader View is click it. Now of course the first thing you'll notice is that just about everything on the page goes away except the article. So you've got just the text, the headline, and the body of the text, but other things are included, like for instance images, sometimes blocks like for links to social media things and sharing links and things like that. But it's far cleaner than if you just viewed the regular page. But in addition to that, you've got some more controls. So one of the reasons to use the Reader View is maybe the text on the page is too small, or sometimes the text, the font isn't good, sometimes the text is gray rather than black and you find it difficult to read. So once you're in Reader View, you can adjust the text very easily by clicking here in these two little capital A's. Once I click there, I get this little control that allows me to adjust the text. I can increase the font size very easily. I can change the background. You can see I could change to a little color there. I can reverse it with a white text on a gray background or white text on a black background. I can also pick from several very readable fonts. So dispensing with the font that the website chose and choosing one of these that may be easier for me to read. So by adjusting all of these things, I could make this article a little easier for me to digest. So to leave the Reader View, all you need to do is just navigate away using a bookmark or maybe a link that's in here, or you could just simply turn it off using the same button that you used to turn it on. So this is useful because, for instance, here there's obviously a video included with this article, so by turning it off I can reveal the video again. So let's look at another site. Let's look at MacMost.com. So here I am at the home page, and this is an article, but this is of course the home page with lists of tutorials. So there's no Reader View here. Safari is smart enough to know that this isn't an article. But if I were to go to the first video here, you can see now that I am in an article, I have Reader View. So I will activate it. Now notice in this case, because of the way that I put the video on the page, the video actually is there in Reader View. So some sites are going to have the video presented in a way that Reader View will include it, and some sites will have it in a way that excludes it from Reader View. And there's not much else here. You can see that the comments and the transcript aren't picked up by Reader View. So you can kind of use the regular version of the page to go back and see all of that stuff. But it's important to note that sometimes you don't get Reader View, like when you're on a home page. Sometimes you won't get it if the article is formatted in a strange way. And what you get in Reader View sometimes will vary. Like sometimes you'll get a video or images and sometimes you won't. But for the most part, for nice long articles, Reader View is a good way to go if you want to concentrate on the content.